Good morning, girls and boys. Today is the 14th Sunday after Pentecost. And today we have Jesus talking to his disciples about how to be a good friend. You know, Christian friendship is a really powerful thing, and God wants us to be in relationship with each other and with God. So I want you to pay close attention and listen to what Jesus has to say about being a good friend. So let's open our hearts and our minds and worship God in spirit and truth. Let us begin. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and blessed be God's kingdom now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Grant us, O Lord, to trust in you with all our hearts, for as you always resist the proud who confide in their own strength, so you never forsake those who make their boast of your mercy, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 18, verses 15 to 20. Jesus said, "If you have a problem with another member of the church, talk to them about it when the two of you are alone. If that person listens to you, that's great. If they don't listen, find one or two other people to go with you to talk, so you have witnesses. If the other person still refuses to listen, let the church know. And if even that doesn't work, just let them go. God will honor what you do here on earth if you do it in Jesus' name, like putting things together or taking them apart. If you ask for something, God will do it for you. Know that whenever two or three of you are together in my name, I will be right there with you. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Well, hey, guess what I have here? Well, of course, it's a balloon. We all know balloons. They're a lot of fun, and the way balloons grow is by we breathe into it to make them bigger, right? Right. Well, I want to talk to you about friendship today, and I want to use this balloon as an example. Now, think with me about, imagine that this balloon is a person, okay? And inside, the air inside, are words and actions that people do to each other. And so when I'm with my friend and I say something hurtful, their balloon gets bigger. And if I say something kind, their balloon gets smaller. But if, you know, we keep saying hurtful things, we keep doing hurtful things to our friends, eventually that balloon gets really big. So we want to be sure that we start doing nice things so that their balloon does not get overloaded. Because you know what happens when that balloon gets overloaded? This is what happens. Woo! Did you see that stuff that came out of there? Oh my gosh! It popped. I can't believe it. Well, that's what happens sometimes with our friends. You know, when we're hurtful and unkind to them, it just grows and grows in them, and then pop, ugly stuff comes out. And they say, they yell at us, or we yell at them when we're hurt, and we say, we don't want to be your friend no more. Well, our story today is Jesus talking to his disciples, because they were having a little difficulty being friends with each other. And so Jesus was trying to tell them that it's important to be careful of the words we say and the way we treat each other. But if we happen to hurt somebody's feelings, then Jesus told his disciples to go to them and to talk to them. You see, God really values our friendships. And God wants us to stay together. But when we don't, when we hurt people's feelings, or they hurt our feelings and we don't talk about it, well, they can get either sad or really angry. I mean, just look at our world today. These grown-ups are yelling at each other, and some are getting depressed because they're not talking to each other. Well, the beautiful thing of our story today is Jesus tells us how to do that. That when our feelings get really hurt, we need to go to each other and talk to each other. Now, it's not an easy thing, is it? No. Sometimes we have to get some help. Maybe have a friend go with us, or even have our parents, or maybe Mother Mary needs to help us, you know, to talk it out. Because when we talk it out, then we're together again, aren't we? You know, sometimes though, I want you to be aware that sometimes people don't want to talk to you. Well, when that happens, we've got to just let them go and pray for them. Now, why is it important, do you think, that Jesus wants us to stay friends? Well, I think the answer to that is at the end of the story. When Jesus says, where two or three are gathered together in his name, he's right there in the middle. That's right. You see, here's the secret to friendship. It's powerful. God wants us to be friends because when we are together, we are much stronger. When we are together, we are more loving and kind. When we are together, our hearts are open. And right in the middle of all that, is Jesus. So the good news for today is that friendships count and they're important to us. And we need to talk to each other and make sure we don't hold it all in. Because when we do that, poof, it explodes. And we don't need our friends or our own hearts exploding, do we? No, we don't. So let us join together and talk it out so that we can all understand each other. Let us pray. Dear Jesus, we thank you for friendship, and we thank you that you are in the midst of our friendship. We ask that you continue to help us talk to each other and not hold it in and become angry or sad. We thank you, Jesus, that your Holy Spirit is guiding us all the time. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen.
We pray that coaches support us. The team, that they support the team and make sure we have fun. God hears us when we pray. God, we pray for our president, members of Congress, our governor, and our local officials. We pray they make good choices, have integrity, are honest and open to new ideas. We pray they work together to make good decisions for everyone. God hears us when we pray. God, we pray for people with disabilities who are in need of help, those who can't be helped, and those who don't know they need help. God hears us when we pray. God, we pray for those who have died and ask you to comfort those who mourn. God hears us when we pray. God, we pray for us. Guide each one of us and show us the path we should take. Strengthen us, keep us believing in ourselves, and teach us to be grateful for what we have. Remind us you love us and watch over us every day. God hears us when we pray. God, we pray for the world. We pray for countries in need or in trouble. We pray that you help us to keep the world clean, safe, and peaceful. Help everyone to get along and build friendships. God hears us when we pray. Amen.
As our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Well, boys and girls, we've learned some amazing things about God and about how we are to be God's children. We've learned that Jesus wants us to value our friendship because God values our friendship. That you and I, when we have hurt feelings, that we need to talk about it and not hold them in, because that can be very destructive. So, in order to have the friendships that we're supposed to have, we need to be willing to go and talk to the person that we either hurt or who hurt us. And remember, when we do that, then we are able to join together as the body of Christ and as children of God. Because there's power in staying connected to each other. Remember, Jesus said, when there's two or three of us gathered together, when our hearts are open to each other, Jesus is there in the middle of it. Isn't that amazing? Wow. So, you know, every time we learn something new, God asks us not to just keep it to ourselves, but to share it with those that we come in contact with, because they need to know that Jesus loves them and cares about them. And always remember, whether we are together or apart, we always connect with the heart. God bless, and see you next Sunday.
Just like